War. War never changes. Hey everybody, it's Accurize. Welcome to Fallout 4. I've been waiting for this for about 5 years. It's by far my most favorite gaming franchise. I've been playing this since Fallout 1 back in the 90s. I remember after Fallout 2, Black Isle folded and everyone wondered if the franchise was dead for several years. Well, it's alive and well and kicking, so I'm a happy guy. Just wait for the movie now, because you know it's coming. Here we go.
War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
All right, here we go. Character creation.
War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Alright. Well, the face is alright to me. Let's go ahead and see if we can... Okay, there we go. We can style the hair here. Gotta get rid of that hair. Males in my family, we don't like hair, apparently. There we go. Looks pretty good.
New hairstyle.
Except,
I like it.
Let's see if we can... Facial hair. Yeah, okay. There we go.
What do you think, hon? Roguishly handsome or handsomely roguish?
I was looking for facial hair. There we go. Alright, lazy morning. Gotta get something a little bit apocalyptic looking. That looks pretty good. Lonely Wanderer was pretty good. That facial hair just looks fake. Looks like it's all glued on. It's the San Francisco Giants. Oh. No, not quite. Alright, let's find the one. There we go. I think I'll go with that one.
Ooh, I like the beard.
Good deal. Okay. Confirm character? Sure. Alright. Well, let's talk to Nora.
I'll just be a minute.
Yes. We know how long those minutes are. Hmm. No, let's turn off this radio here. I'm afraid that we'll get flagged for copyright infringement because of the music that's playing. What we got here? Anything? Braxo. Can I use it?
A Braxo for all your cleaning needs.
Honey, what are these strange boxes doing in this strange room? Feels so strange being in there.
Good morning, sir. Your coffee. 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Brew to perfection.
Wow.
And today's newspaper just delivered.
I can't tell whether to feel threatened by him or feel... Oh, there we go. My coffee disappeared. Probably in my hand.
Hey, Codsworth.
Enjoy your coffee, sir.
Or feel comforted by his presence and protection. I like that. Alright. Newspaper?
More of the same.
Uh-oh.
Oh, sounds like someone made a stinky. I shall attend to young Shaw.
You know, gonna change my baby's diaper with...
But Codsworth's really good with Sean.
He's changing our diaper with a buzzsaw blade as an arm. I don't know how well this is going to work out. Okay. American flag.
Good old USA.
Yep.
I'm so proud of her.
Suffolk County School of Law, Boston, Massachusetts. Because she's wicked smart. All right. You knew you had to say it at least once. Sugar bombs.
Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar.
What's wrong with that? Milk?
Looks like the milk got delivered. Nuka-Cola. Ice cold.
Alright.
It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Where's your curious monkey at? Alright, Vault-Tec. Yeah.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir. And helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
I'm here now.
I'm here now.
So you are. So you are.
That was weird.
Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Wow. Is there enough space?
But there's room for my entire family, right?
Of course. Of course. Minus your robot, naturally. In fact, you're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
Okay.
Sure. Let's do it.
Splendid! Splendid. Now, let's see.
Alright, so, I guess I get to tell us about yourself. Vault-Tec needs to know what kind of citizen you are to ensure your future happiness. Well, my name is Accurize. Okay, my strength is... Wait a minute, maybe I have to push enter. There we go, okay. Hey, quit it. There we go. Strength is a measure of your raw physical power. It affects how much you can carry and the damage of all melee attacks. Well, that sounds kind of important. Okay. Perception is your environmental awareness and sixth sense. It affects weapon accuracy and advance. I'm thinking that's probably pretty important right there. Probably really want that to be high. Endurance is a measure of your overall physical... I'm thinking I want all these to be very high. Endurance is a measure of your overall physical fitness. It affects your total health and the action points drain from sprinting. Yeah, we'll go with 3, you know. Charisma. Charisma is your ability to charm and convince others. It affects your success to persuade in dialogue and prices when you barter. Now, I found charisma to be kind of helpful because it opens up new dialogue trees and things like that. So I do want this one to be, decent at least. Intelligence is a measure of your overall mental acuity and affects the number of experience points earned. So it's always good. Agility measures your overall finesse and reflexes. It affects the number of action points in vets and your ability to sneak. Just kind of waiting for him just to wipe out there. Think he will? I think he's got pretty good agility. All right, let's see if we can maybe pull one from a perception and maybe add it to luck. Pretty happy with that. That looks good. All right, good enough. We normally get to add these later on as we, level up and things like that. So.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
No free offer is too high.
I have my moments.
Uh-oh. What'd you do, Cosworth?
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down.
Well,
I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
I wonder why he's refusing to calm down. You're shooting fire out of your butt, and you got a buzzsaw blade for an arm. All right, Sean. Sean. Hey, buddy. I'm going to play with you.
How Coochie are the coo. Two most important men in my life doing?
Coochie coo.
Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that.
Don't tell me what to do. I'm going to spin the mobile a bit like I was planning on doing in the first place. Because he loves it.
Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
All right.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir, Mom, you should come and see this.
Codsworth, what's wrong?
Well, so speaking of the park, whenever I take my little one to the park, my little toddler, I always like to take my mom or my wife with me because she throws a fit when it's time to go home, and it looks like I'm actually abducting her when I pick her up and take her to the car. So it always helps if you have a older female or someone that looks to be your wife with you when your kid is screaming and kicking, yelling no, no, no as you carry them off to the car.
By flashes, blinding flashes,
so.
Sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations.
Something about explosions.
Oh, no.
We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports, I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in
Pennsylvania.
My God.
This is one of those you'll remember what you were doing moments.
Oh my God.
Whoa, don't drop the baby.
Now!
I've got Sean.
Okay.
Let's go.
Just don't drop the baby.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills.
Maybe we should use the sidewalk.
Evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Maybe we should use the sidewalk. It's right here. Hey, can I talk to you?
Hey there.
This way, all vault participants.
Oh, apparently not. Okay, let's go. We got some like osprey looking things up there. How about you? Can I talk to you?
The gate to the vault is that way, sir.
Okay.
That's absurd.
It's in my backyard.
Not on the list. You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop me!
Hey.
Okay. Are they letting you in? And not me?
What the heck? That's weird.
Hear about this.
Not in the vault, if you're in the program,
half step forward, otherwise return home!
Hey there.
Okay.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Hunt.
Thank you.
Let's go.
God, no.
You two, follow
me. Come on. Aha.
What's gonna happen to
we're in.
People outside
we're doing
the gate.
Everything we can. Now aha. Keep moving.
It's because of your vest.
Why don't they let us in?
That's why they didn't let you in. Apocalypse cannot stand fashion faux pas. Wow. Is this my ride? Going in here.
Step on the platform in the center.
This
oh.
Way.
Okay. All right. Make room, people. In the center. Well, you got it right. Everyone
almost
else got
there.
It wrong.
We're gonna be okay. I love you.
I love
both
you.
Both of you.
We love
for
you
following
too.
Directions.
Oh my god!
Incredibly well. Whoa.
No, no! Shut it down now!
Whoa.
Hold on. Can't this thing move faster?
Oh god. Oh god.
This is
oh
gonna
god.
Be an interesting
oh
elevator ride. Oh. That looked painful.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Well, I don't think the rest of the
everyone
people are.
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe
no need to worry.
If we left a minute later...
No, no.
We don't.
Don't get caught up thinking about
hey
that.
Hey there.
Up you're the safe now. Everyone, just head up these
no
stairs.
No need to worry. Never mind the nuclear explosion that just happened down the street.
Just this way, please.
All right.
Male. Male.
Female.
Hello.
Excuse me.
Just step over to the table.
Okay.
You'll welcome need your suits before we
pick
can
up
take
a suit
you further.
Right over there.
Just this way. Thanks. What now?
Just follow the...
Hey.
All right,
it's down the hallway right
me.
There.
Female.
Okay.
See?
Oh.
This is our new home.
Mouse wheel actually
oh,
lets me do third person. That's nice.
This is one of our most
here
advanced
you are.
Facilities.
Head down the hall.
Not
there.
That the others aren't great, mind you. It's gone. Our home.
Everything okay?
Everything we
had.
Made
it.
My mother
sir,
and father down in D.C.
Oh God, honey. How long do you think
it?
We'll be down here?
I know this is a
oh, we'll
time.
Be going over all that
Vault
in orientation.
Tech
just a few medical items we have
to
get through first.
Vault suit is designed to be fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Excuse me.
Follow me.
I am following you. I just have some questions. Maybe we can walk and talk.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
Decontamination pod.
It'll be okay. Daddy's right here. See? Honey.
Hmm. Okay.
Could you...
Sorry. Gotta get decontaminated.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Sounds good.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals. Normal. Procedure complete.
I imagine heart rate would be kind of high.
Four,
wait a minute, they're freezing me.
Three, two, one.
I just got cryogenically frozen, I think. Well, heart rate has decreased a lot now. Hmm. Manual override, huh? So somebody's manually stopping our sleep here. Wonder how long we've been asleep.
Here.
Can I get out of here?
Open it.
What?
Almost.
Can't get out of here. Hey. Don't. Look at my son. Oh. Alright. Remember that face. I'll be seeing you a little later. Don't you worry. Did I just get refrozen again? Wow. I wonder who let me out this time. Okay. Well, out of time. Exit vault 111. Can I open these at all?
God. Why would Vault do this?
Come on! There has to be a release!
Pressure release right there. Wait, can I do this?
Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
Oh, there we go.
I'll find who did this, and I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Okay, open this one. Oh, it won't let me open that one. Well,
hello?
I think. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe we can use this.
Anyone?
Thank you for choosing Vault-Tec, man. Cryogenic array. Premature termination resulted in system failure, isolated, manual, and remote overrides detected, controls disabled. Life support. Offline, premature termination, same thing. Pod occupant status, I guess it's going to be the same thing. Oh, maybe not. Let's check the status here. Unknown pod override, pod door manual override engage. Maybe I can do something here. Let's try this one, see what it says. Override engage, okay. Maybe I can free one of these other people. Let's try Mr. Russell. Deceased, cause of death, asphyxiation due to life support failure. Wow, are they all gonna be that way? Deceased, cause of death, no, same thing. Try one more. Same thing. Alright. So. Okay, I can take a hint. Alright, let's get out of here. Do I need anything out of here? Let's see. Anything, can I do anything? Does not look like it. Alright. Does he seem to be walking around? Got this door? What do we got here?
It's stuck.
Stuck. Okay, great. Take a screwdriver, I guess. Just a wrench. Hammer? That might be a weapon. I don't know. Okay, let's head this way. That's a huge cockroach. Whoa. What we got in here? Anything worthwhile? Stimpak. Alright, good. That's a good start. That is some old coffee, I have a feeling. Better clipboard, cigarette. Let's take the cigarette. So, one of the features that they have in this game, I've been doing some reading on it, was that now you can actually set up your own communities and have them interact and sort of set up a network of communities. And you can craft things for your community. And I guess all things can be broken down into different components. So even like clipboards and lamps and telephones and things like that, they can be stripped. Like, for example, a telephone could be like stripped down and the copper can be extracted from it. Oh. I need a something to hit this thing. What is this? That looks good. Alright, good deal. Baton equipped. Oh, whoa. Okay. Let's beat the crap out of this thing. Eat accept. Oh. Apparently I just needed a good set of boots. Take the rad...
Giant... roaches?
Rad roach
what
meat.
What the hell?
So, basically, it's good to accumulate junk from what I've been seeing. So just basically pick up everything and dump it at your home base. Recreational terminal? Overseer memo, let's read that. Remember, the use of the recreational terminal is privileged. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked. Enjoy responsibly. Top 10. Rick Tim messages. Okay. Red Menace start game. Okay. That's a Donkey Kong. Sort of. And they want to talk to us about copyright infringement. Come on now. All right, 100 points. Run. 50 meters. Looks like these are, wow, that's kind of tough. I have no idea why I'm playing this. Let's get out of here. Yes. All right. That was pointless. Let's try to actually survive the apocalypse rather than play a Donkey Kong knockoff. Anything in here? No. Sink. I can get drinks. Normally that restores some hit points. It's clean water. Looks like it was Oplate. I'm going to grab that. I'm sure that there's components in there. Same with the toaster. I wonder if I can look at my inventory or something. How to get to my inventory. Don't know how to do that yet. I'm sure they'll bring it up. Okay. Sink, drink. No toilet water in this particular game. All right, so that's where it came in at. Let's keep moving. Let's keep on keeping on. All right. Nothing in here. Wow. This is really ransacked. Another thing is typically you can sleep if the game allows you to and restore hit points that way. But apparently not. I already came in this way. I don't need to go this way. Yes. Hence the little green clue. Alright, let's not. Ooh. That red. Or that. The red roach got killed pretty good there.
Where is everyone?
Well, I don't know. I'm not going after that rad roach meat. Cooked rad roach. Nice. I am a roach-killing machine up in here. Restore our hit points there. What we got here? Hey, a pistol. 10mm. And a lot of stim packs. Alright, stim packs are 30% of your max health. Restore 30% of it. Heal damaged limbs and can be favorited for quick use. Okay, how do you favorite? Actually, how do you even get into your inventory? That's the question. Skeleton?
Is this all that's left?
It's not much help. Overseer's terminal. Overseer eyes only. Oh, okay. Confidential, confidential, confidential. Overseer eyes only. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects, like my family. Your staff will be on short-term assignment to monitor basic cardiopulmonary and cognitive functions. Long-term monitoring will be handled remotely by Vault Tech technicians. Under no circumstances is suspension to be disrupted. This includes the administration of life-saving measures. Your staff is also considered expendable. Insubordination or attempts to evacuate prematurely are capital violations. Unused cryogenic pods are the preferred method for cadaver disposal. Okay. That's a cheery letter right there. I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available in a portable on-demand form. The cryolighter is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. Okay. Someone was working on a portable version of the cryopod. Operations protocol manual. Residence admittance. Upon activation notice from Vault Tech, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of Vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for for residents' intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcefully by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstance. Okay. Staff duties. Oh my gosh. So science staff must daily monitor the vital signs of cryogenically preserved residents. Cardiopulmonary cognitive ability or activity in particular must be recorded hourly. Life-saving interventions is only permitted if greater than 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension and must not interrupt suspension. So if there's only 20% of the people left, I guess they're allowed to help you, as long as it doesn't interrupt your sleep. Independent research is encouraged and left to oversee your discretion. Security personnel. Security patrols will be carried out in constant 8-hour rotation. Security priorities include monitoring signs of intrusion, checking for atmosphere leaks, settling disputes among personnel, enforcement of regulations set forth by the overseer, enforcement of regulations set forth by Vault Tech. Due to the nature of Vault 111, personnel will be expected to perform duties outside of their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food preparation. The exact distribution of these roles is left to the overseer discretion. Okay. All clear in evacuation. All clear message. Following a nuclear event, Vault Tech will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasion, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, this terminal will receive an all-clear notice. Upon receiving an all-clear notice, the Vault Tech personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault Tech, including government and military. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault Tech will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff has been evacuated. I wonder if that's how I got cut loose. Remotely. Mandatory shelter period. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while awaiting the all-clear signal to evacuate. In the absence of an all-clear message from Vault Tech, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstances may Vault 111 staff evacuate during this shelter period unless receiving the all-clear message from Vault Tech. Okay. I think that's everything. Right. Wait, nope. Overseer log. Wow. It's happened. We're lucky we're the most prepared staff. That most of the staff was nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected. Only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. I wonder if that was the guy who was in the yellow jacket and hat. Residence admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute. I think that was me. I was worried that there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for those people. They must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. Let's do preparations. Final staff orientation is complete. All but a few have of the residents down in the Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled. Several from Concord as well. Vault Tech supervisors came up this week to do a technical review with me. The vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time. I almost wish I could... Yeah, but how much time? That's the question. I almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized. Alright, system malfunction. Oh, this will be interesting. Strange issue today at Pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. Can't remember who's in C3. Was that my wife? We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault Tech's remote override system may have sent an errant signal. We have to keep an eye out. I only hope that their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. Supplies running low. There's been no all clear signal yet, and even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period, supplies were never intended to last much more than that. And despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up, they're insane. The radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everybody if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all-clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just... move forward. Maybe enter? There we go. Have to keep everything under control until the all-clear. Mutiny! Even more interesting. A faction led by the security personnel have turned on me. That's normally how it works. Demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I will not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left. I've been too damn generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well, that's fewer mouths to feed. All right. Open evacuation tunnel. Ah, here we go. Personal evacuation tunnel is now open. Remind all staff to be orderly and follow shutdown protocols before exiting and resealing Vault 111. Please maintain all staff records and research. Report to local Vault Tech superiors for a debrief and further instructions. Alright. Well, that answers that. What are these? Eyeglasses. I wonder what I can do. Can I put those on? I want to put those on. How do I put these on? I kind of like the third person, actually. I'm trying to figure out how to get into my menu. Okay. Again, I'm sure it'll tell me eventually. Another pistol? Okay. More ammo? More ammo? What's this? Cryolator case.
Nice.
Unlock.
Coming back later for you.
No bobby pins. Takes a master skill level. We'll definitely be back for that. Was there anything in there? Oh, yes. Take the pencil, too. Never know when you need a good pencil. Alright. Dresser. What's this? Preserved cigarette pack. Alright. Anything in here? Ah, bobby pins. Very nice. Bobby pins, if memory serves, from prior episodes. Aim your gun. Okay. Oh, shoot. Whoa, I'll just hit Q apparently instead. Red Urge. Ah! Stop hitting me. Man, I keep getting hit by these things. Tearing me up. I'm gonna die from roach attack. Is that it? Nope, one more. Get off me. Is that it? My gosh. They were never ending. I wasn't that good. That was kind of horrible, actually. Well, at least I got plenty of ammo. I got 82 rounds. That's pretty good. Let's keep moving. Press R to reload a gun. Well, I just did that. Sort of instinct, actually. Anything else over here? No. Let's go this way. Okay, let's see if we can just shoot this thing from a distance. Gotcha. Avoid bright light. Use melee attacks and move slowly. Caps locks. To remain undetected. Oh, okay. Press left alt to perform melee attack while holding it. Okay. So, can I? Okay, I'm hit. Oh, okay. That's kind of neat. Alright. Alright, not that worried. Oh. Some more ammo. Not that worried about being sneaky right now, at least. I don't think I need to. Whoa. I'll get you. Hold on. See that crit down there? I think that's critical. I keep it's going up every time I attack one of these things. It's like building, like charging it up or something. Take Pip Boy. Oh yeah. I put you right on my left forearm. Home sweet home. Oh, I bet you that's why I couldn't get my inventory, because I didn't have a Pip Boy. That's pretty cool. Wipe away the dust. 64K of RAM. Select tab. Select a tab with mouse 1, okay. Change sections with A and D. Okay. There we go. So we got a map. Got our inventory. Can we move our map around? Yeah, we sure can. Wow. This map's pretty big. I think this is where we started at. I think this is our little home area, maybe. Okay. Stats. See how we're doing here. Hit points. Yeah, we're doing all right. Action points, 80 out of 80. Levels there. This is our primary weapon. This is our damage from that weapon. This is armor, I guess. That's shock resistance and maybe radiation resistance. So I don't think we have any actual armor resistance yet. Perception, okay. All of our skills. Perks, no perks at this point. Alright, inventory, security baton. That does pretty decent damage, actually. That's a little bit better, though. And we're carrying 21 out of 250 overall carry capacity. And these are, I guess those are bottle caps. It's typically the currency in the wasteland. Eyeglasses. Oh, I think we get a... Yeah, we get a perception one if we wear those. Let's see if we wear those. Okay, let's see what our stats are now. Did they go up? Yes. Yes, we got a plus next to it now. So we our perception went up one because of our eyeglasses. Very good. So we got forced impacts and some rad meat, which we could eat, but does have radiation attached to it. Be better just to sleep if possible, typically. Or drink clean water, I guess. Got a bunch of this stuff. Can I look at this? See what... Oh. Yeah, I can zoom in. Sort component view. Maybe that's what I should do. Try to see. Component view. What is this? Cloth? Copper? Hot plate. Oh, okay. So I can get these things... A gear I can make from the adjustable wrench, I guess. Lead from the pencil. Actually, it's graphite, but okay. Plastic from the preserves. Oh, okay, that's interesting. So it's showing what I'm getting all these from. Steel I'm getting from the adjustable wrench, ball peen hammer, screwdriver, toaster, and wrench. Okay. Wait a minute, what was this? Tag for search? Oh, I heard about this. I guess when you're looking for a specific component, you can... tag it, and then everything in the world that has it will have some sort of an indicator next to it or something. Perks chart? What's that? Oh. Okay. So this is our overall perks. Our base skills. Alright, then we got on here. This looks like level 1. So I'm guessing we can pick these items or pick these different perks. But we require one agility there, and you can get Channel Spirit of Old West non-automatic pistols do 20% more damage. Now, there's one down here that's called, I guess we can't go down that far. Can we go down further? No, it doesn't let me see any further than that. There's one that's, like, called, I'll know it when I see it. Basically has to do with you being able to connect your communities together. And everyone says that that's like a really good perk to get. I always like bloody mess. Oh, now it's not just gory kills. You actually get 5% bonus damage with it now. Used to just be the visual bonus. Okay, mods, ammo, 102 rounds, radio. Okay, good. Glad that that's off. Okay, well that looks pretty good. Vault door. Okay, activate. Remote access ready. Yes.
Vault door cycling.
Exit vault 111.
Please stand back.
Okay, I'll move away. What's down here? Oh, I probably don't want to drink that water. It's probably dirty. There's anything down here that I can grab. I don't see anything. Nope. That is a big door right there. It's like NORAD. Alright. What is this? What is that down there? What is it? Oh, just papers. Random papers. Oh, the elevator came down for me. Just looking for any ammo laying around, anything. It's worthy. Worthy of my inventory. Okay, let's head on in here. Do you want to change any? Oh, this is where you get to do a last minute change if you not quite committed to your character. Change any special attributes, change appearance, finish. I think we're good. So, alright, let's go ahead and exit the vault. I guess we'll go ahead and end episode one here. And I'll see you guys when we enter the wasteland. So like, comment, subscribe, hit that tip jar, or head on over to patreon.com/accurize2 and pledge a donation, become a producer on the videos. Thank you so much for watching. See you in episode 2.